हेलो, नाउ आई एम अगेन बैक विथ माय वीडियो. लास्ट वीडियो देयर वाज सम डिस्टरबेंस, यू नो, दैट विच आई कुड नॉट कंट्रोल एंड दैट वाज क्वाइट अनअवॉइडेबल. सो बैकग्राउंड यू माइट बी हियरिंग सम नॉइजेस. सी, आई एम मेकिंग दीज वीडियोस अंडर यू नो लॉकडाउन सर्कमस्टेंसेज विद वेरी लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज इन माय होम. सो देयर माइट बी सम डिस्टर्बेंसेज, सो प्लीज इग्नोर दैट एंड पे अटेंशन टू व्हाट आई एम टीचिंग. ओके, लास्ट टाइम आई रिमेम्बर आई गेव यू टू टू थ्री क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो टुडे आई विल जस्ट डिस्कस दोज क्वेश्चंस एंड फाइंड आउट वेदर यू कुड फाइंड आउट द आंसर करेक्टली और नॉट. ओके, द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वॉज एथेनॉल एंड ग्लूकोज. नाउ आई टोल्ड यू दैट दे बोथ यू हैव ethanol and glucose. Now they both contain hydrogen, yet they are not acids. Why? Well, it's very simple. According to Arrhenius' concept, acids are compounds which, when dissolved in water, dissociate to give hydronium ions. Okay, but when you take ethanol and glucose, they never ionize in water. You dissolve it in water, they will get dissolved, but they never ionize. Thus, they don't produce any hydronium ions, and that's why they are not acids. Okay, so this was the first question. Now, what was the second question? The second question was, yes, whether acids conduct electricity or not. So in your NCERT book there is an experiment also which is given, where you are taking in a beaker, you can take two beakers, and in one beaker you can put glucose solution, in other beaker you can put dilute hydrochloric acid, you can take water and add a little bit of acid to it, hydrochloric acid, and then put two electrodes, right? And positive and negative electrode, and then connect it to a bulb, right? So you will find that the bulb which is attached to the set in which acid is present in the beaker, the electrodes are dipped in acidic solution, that bulb starts glowing. And the other one in where the electrodes are dipped in glucose solution, it doesn't glow. So what does it indicate? It indicates that acids are good conductors of electricity. And you know, it's very simple, because acids ionize. They ionize to give ions. So when ions are there, conduction of electricity is definitely there. Okay, so that's why when we take pure water or distilled water, you know, distilled water is not a good conductor of electricity. So to make it a better conductor of electricity, we add a little bit of acid to it. Or even when you simply take water, if you add a little bit of acid to it, it becomes a very good conductor of electricity. Okay, well, now my third question was that I take HCl gas, HCl in gaseous form, and I try dry litmus paper. So this is a test tube, and HCl gas is produced through some experiment. You can produce HCl gas, and then you have this dry HCl gas coming out, and you bring this blue litmus paper which is dry. Okay, which is dry, right? So will the color change or not? The color will not change. The color will not change, the blue litmus color. And you will say, okay, why? It is an acid. Actually, the problem is that there is no moisture. Okay, so without water, ionization of HCl will not happen, and hydronium ions will not be formed. And without hydronium ions, acidic property of any compound cannot be shown. Okay, so a dry blue litmus paper's color will never change in HCl gas. Either you have to moisten this blue litmus paper, you just dip it in water and bring it, it will change to red, or you have to, you know, take this HCl gas, dissolve it in water, and then dip the dry blue litmus paper to it. Is it clear? So these were the three questions which I discussed, which I asked in your in my previous video. And now with these questions and the answers which I gave you, I think the concept about acids is very clear to you. Okay. Now talking about the bases. When I talk of bases, according to Arrhenius' concept, any substance when dissolved in water dissociate to give hydroxyl ions. This, okay, hydroxyl ions. Hydroxyl ions, they are called as bases. Okay, just like acids. So normally the way all the concepts of acids can be applied to bases. If the only difference is hydroxyl ions. Okay, so when I am talking about strong base and weak base, here also it depends on the degree of ionization. Okay, so there are very strong bases, for example potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide. So when we dissolve it in water, they completely dissociate, almost completely dissociate or ionize to produce large number of hydroxyl ions. Okay, then there are like weak bases like ammonium hydroxide. They do not completely ionize and produce lesser number of hydroxyl ions. Okay. Similarly, bases are also good conductors of electricity. Bases also require moisture to ionize, and then only they will give that litmus test. Okay. Similarly, dilution of bases, the concept is same that of acids. You should not add water to any base to dilute it. You have to add base to a cold water and with constant stirring. Okay, so that's how you are going to dilute the base, right? So I think the concept of acids and bases is very, very clear to you. In my next video, I'll be talking about pH, and then I will move on to chemical properties of acids and bases.